Hi, I'm Amy from the Alt Store. I'm going to show you the difference between 60-cell solar panels and 72-cell solar panels. Other than the obvious difference of 12 solar cells, there are pros and cons to using each of them in different solar power systems. First, a little background. Solar panels are made from blocks of silicon ingots that are cut into square cells. Those are the squares that you see that make up the solar panels. Each solar cell produces about a half a volt. They then wire multiple cells in series, plus to minus, to make a solar panel. Wiring the cells in series increases the solar panel voltage to a usable level. The more cells that are wired in series, the higher the voltage. For example, if 36 cells are wired in series, you get an output of about 18 volts. Now, solar first got its start in the battery-based off-grid world, where solar panels were built to charge a battery bank. The 36-cell solar panel that outputs 18 volts is perfect for charging a 12-volt battery bank, since you need a higher voltage to charge a battery. So a 36-cell solar panel is called a 12-volt nominal panel, as it's designed to charge a 12-volt battery. Likewise, a solar panel with twice as many cells, 72 cells, outputs about 36 volts, and it's great for charging a 24-volt battery bank. So it's called, you got it, a 24-volt nominal solar panel. If you have a 48-volt battery bank, there aren't many companies that make 48-volt solar panels. So in that case, what do you do if you need to charge a 48-volt battery bank? You would wire multiple solar panels together in series, either four 12-volt panels or two 24-volt panels to output 72 volts, which will efficiently charge a 48-volt battery bank even in very hot weather when the voltage of silicon panels drops low. For an example of the effects that heat has on solar panels, check out this video we did on temperature and silicon solar panels. So, all was well and good with figuring out what nominal voltage solar panels to use. Just make them match the nominal voltage of the batteries. When along came two different technologies that added an interesting twist to the mix. The first was grid-tie solar. With a grid-tie inverter, you could now convert the DC voltage from the solar panels directly to AC to power your house. No batteries required. So the restriction of 12-volt, 24-volt, and 48-volt went away. This allowed solar panel manufacturers to use however many cells they wanted to. For solar panels up to about 300 watts, the industry settled on 60 cells. Using the terminology from the battery world, that's a 20-volt nominal panel. With an open circuit voltage, or VOC, of around 38 volts, grid-tie solar systems are able to string up to 12 or 13 60-cell solar panels in series and stay within the electrical code restriction of staying under 600 volts DC, even when taking cold temperature into consideration. If they were using 24-volt 72-cell panels, they would be limited to only 11 in series in cold environments, limiting their system size. The second change was still in the battery-based world, where the solar charge controllers that are used to manage putting the power from the solar panels into the batteries. Early on, the pulse width modulated, or PWM, charge controllers had to match the nominal voltage between the solar panels and the battery bank. Maximum power point tracking, MPPT, solar charge controllers came onto the scene and allowed you to take a higher voltage solar input and reduce the charge controller voltage output to correctly charge a battery bank while increasing the output current, eliminating any power loss due to forcing solar panels to operate at whatever voltage the battery bank was actually at. This opened up the possibility to any count solar panels, as long as the voltage was higher than the battery bank. Although some specialized charge controllers allow you to charge with a lower voltage solar panel, most of them require a higher voltage. Since 60-cell grid-tie solar panels are so common now, their price per watt has dropped much lower than the more niche 12-volt panels, making them an attractive option to charge battery banks. Just remember, you have to use more expensive MPPT charge controller to do it. Also note that you cannot use a single 60-cell solar panel to charge a 24-volt battery bank. you need at least one 72-cell panel or two 60-cell panels in series to have a voltage high enough to charge 24 volts. If you're in a cold environment, most 150-volt MPPT solar charge controllers limit you to up to only two 72-cell panels in series, but you can do up to three 60-cell panels in series and still stay within that 150-volt limit. So what about the 72-cell, 24-volt solar panels for grid-tied systems? Well, technology and codes move forward, and newer revisions of the electric code now allow for 1,000-volt strings for commercial and utility-scale systems. Also, grid-tied inverters are getting bigger and bigger, allowing for extremely high wattages getting inverted. Since watts equals volts times amps, a way to increase the wattage of a solar panel is to increase the voltage by adding additional cells. Adding those 12 more cells generally adds an additional foot of length to the solar panels. With larger commercial and utility scale projects, larger panel sizes are able to be used. So 72 cell panels give them a way to regularly make solar panels well over 300 watts. Higher wattage solar panels reduces the number of panels that are needed in the system to reach your target wattage, which can decrease the labor needed to install them. Higher wattage panels may also reduce the amount of balance of system equipment needed, including racking, wire, and in some cases, the electronics themselves if they're using microinverters or DC optimizers. Now note that not all microinverters will support 72-cell solar panels, so 60-cell is still the only option in some cases, mostly for home systems. Most 72-cell panels still weigh less than the 50-pound restriction set by OSHA, so can be carried by one person, although their size can make it awkward to handle alone. The smaller 60-cell solar panels can be easier to handle. So, what size solar panel you should use for your project depends on a lot of criteria. Are you building an off-grid or a grid-tie solar system? If it is off-grid, what voltage battery bank are you trying to charge? Do you have a physical size restriction that would limit the size of the panel? Will the equipment you want to use support the solar panel? Will a higher voltage panel restrict the number of panels you can use in a system? These are all questions you need to ask to determine what size panels are right for you. Give us a call at the Altis store and we'd be happy to help you get what you need. I hope this was helpful. If so, give us a like and a share and subscribe to our Altis store channel so we'll notify you when we release a new video. And be sure to check out our selection of solar products at altisstore.com. Well, we've been making renewable doable since 1999.